June 2013, I was going through a very dark time in my life. I had lost a 16-year relationship. My three children were not speaking to me. I was not allowed to see five of my grandchildren. And I was alone in a four-bedroom house. And my prayers were pleading to God, please help me. There was a pamphlet in my mailbox that said, come in for a free Bible study. And I thought, is this the answer to my prayers? And I went to Precept Ministries where they had it. And I met a really great bunch of women, and they loved me, and they were kind, and they embraced me. And on top of that, they showed me how to start reading the Bible so that I could understand it and study it myself. And I learned from the forgiveness book that we did that God forgave me for everything. And I had thought, who am I not to forgive? So I called my children and I apologized and asked their forgiveness. And the best thing that came out of that Bible study was the return of my children, the return of my grandkids, and a friendship with my husband that I never thought I would ever have. I had thought I'd lost it all. Almost a year later, I've joined a church, and I can study the Word on my own now, but I still enjoy going to my Bible studies. And I'm getting baptized on Easter Sunday, and that is another step in my spiritual walk with the Lord. And now my life at 50 is about doing things that are pleasing to the Lord, to everything I need to know how to live in this world is in this Bible.
When I was three, I had a traumatic event in my life. My family was involved in a car accident, and my biological father died. And I think at three, it's difficult to understand that someone is gone forever. What does dead mean, you know? And so I would ask my mom, when can I see my daddy again? I really want to see him again. And I remember there was this one day where we were sitting on the floor in her bedroom, and she said, you know, daddy's in heaven and you can see him again, but you have to accept Jesus into your heart. And I don't think at three I really understood what it all meant. And I think, well, I know that somewhere along the way I started trying to earn my way into heaven. And it just led to this experience of never feeling like I measured up. Every time I read the Bible, it was like, it just came out wrong. There was this filter, there was this wall between God and I, and all I read was condemnation. And I would just try harder and harder, and I just became more and more tightly bound in this sin of trying to be my own God and just completely misunderstanding what he was offering me, what Jesus had done for me. And after 30 years of doing that, I just said, you know what, God, I've had enough. I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not playing this game anymore. You have failed me, and I'm just giving up. And then after a few years of living for myself and just not being happy and things just becoming even more difficult and chaotic and crazy, a friend of mine invited me to the group that we are all in, and we started right into the forgiveness book. And it was the most amazing thing that has ever happened, because I have spent a lot of time trying to forgive people for the past hurts that I've experienced. But I didn't understand what godly forgiveness was. God was speaking to me a lot through this book, but it wasn't till the last week when it really hit me, when Jesus said to the lame man, do you want to be made well? And I just was like, wow, do I want to be well? Do I want to stay in this broken way? Or do I want to be healed. And when I learned that God wants me to forgive, because... Sorry. God wants me to forgive because he wants me to be well. He wants me to do it to be healed, to come into right relationship with him. And I decided to do that, and it has just changed my life.
Beautiful. Amen.